Hey everyone, Dan Ludeman here with Ludeman Productions, and today I wanted to put together a quick little video to show you how I use my Blackmagic LUTs to get work done efficiently and quickly within DaVinci Resolve, and also help me expose while I'm out on the field. Let's get started. Now before we get started, I should point out that I will be using my own LUTs I have for sale in this tutorial. However, that doesn't necessarily mean you need to purchase them. You can still follow along using the free standard Rec 709 LUT from Blackmagic. I've included a download link in the description below. You can also try using your own LUTs, however, your results may be varied depending on the LUT you use. It's worth noting that there are many different ways to color grade. However, this particular method works great for me, especially for efficiency and speed. When I have the time to work on a project, I obviously take much longer time to work on color. Before I get started, I'm also going to assume that you have at least some basic knowledge of DaVinci Resolve. If you don't, no worries. I've attached a few links in the description below to help guide you through more of the basics. So as you can see, I have DaVinci Resolve pulled up here. We have our color tab open and we are ready to start coloring our clips. We have two different types of clips we will be coloring today. Clip 1 is an example of a properly exposed image, shot in B-Raw. Clip 2 is an example of an underexposed image, shot in B-Raw. Now when I say properly exposed image, what I'm referring to is an image that has been exposed to the right. Now if you don't know what that means, I've also included a link in the description below. Let's take a look at clip 1, our properly exposed B-Raw image. Now before we start making our adjustments, we want to make sure we have a few things selected properly in our Camera Raw tab. We want to be sure we have our Decode set to Clip instead of Project, and our Highlights set to Recover. By using the Camera Raw panel and filming in B-Raw, we now have the ability to change our ISO, white balance, tint, and various other adjustments after the fact, even though we've already shot our clip. This is the panel that truly unlocks the power of Blackmagic's B-Raw codec. Now that we've made Camera Raw available to use on our clip, we can now apply our correction LUT. Let's create a node and apply one of our LUTs. Now if you don't see your desired LUTs in this menu, this is because you must first place your LUTs in your DaVinci LUT folder. For my purposes, I'm going to select High Saturation LUT from my LUT pack. Again, you can still follow along using the free Rec 709 LUT included in the description. You can see that we now have a great starting point for coloring. From here, you can modify your image to your liking. I'm not going to dive too much into this color process. I'm going to save that for a more in-depth video in the future. For now, we're just going to stick to the basics on this one. Let's take a look at clip 2, our underexposed clip. Again, let's make sure we have the same Camera Raw setting selected as before. Let's create a node and apply our LUT. Oh no, everything is dark. Well, not to worry. Luckily, we shot everything in Blackmagic Raw and we should be fine here. Now here's the interesting thing about shooting in Blackmagic Raw on Blackmagic Raw cameras. If you originally filmed your image at 1000 ISO or under, you will only be able to choose between the ISO ranges of 100 and 1000 in post. If you originally shot your footage at 1250 ISO or above, you will only be able to select between the ranges of 1250 and 6400 ISO. This is because the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema cameras have dual ISOs, each with their own sensitivity. The lower range ISOs being used for more outdoor environments or well-lit environments, while the higher range ISOs being more ideal for low-light environments. It's important to keep this in mind when filming out in the field. That way, you know what you'll have to work with on the back end. So as you can see, we are only able to push this image to 1000 ISO. We are still going to need to push this image just a little further to get it looking right. To correct this, we can simply raise the exposure slider till we have the desired levels. Now it is worth noting that in most cases, by using this particular slider to raise our exposure artificially, it may introduce unwanted noise to our image. This is not the most ideal way of correcting our exposure. Ideally, this would have been shot originally at 1250 ISO or above, allowing us to resolve our exposure using Camera Raw instead of the exposure slider. Exposing to the right is our best friend. But despite this setback, our image is still holding together, even after pulling it back up in post. This is a huge deal, being able to resolve images like this. You really gotta hand it to the Blackmagic team, they just knocked it out of the park on this one. So if you do plan on using ProRes instead of Blackmagic Raw, these LUTs still will work for you, they'll work totally fine. However, if you miss your exposure using ProRes, you are not gonna have near as much flexibility in post as B-Raw. For example, if you use ProRes and you blow out your highlights and you expose to the right too far, chances are you will lose those highlights. Now, same goes if you underexpose your image in ProRes. You're gonna end up lifting that in post and introducing a lot of noise. So bear that in mind. You really wanna nail your exposure out on the field with ProRes. So you keep hearing me say over and over, expose to the right, expose to the right. If I could leave you with one thing, it would be just that. Try exposing to the right. Not only will these LUTs play a lot better with your footage, but you'll find a lot more success with all cameras by using this method. And that's part of the reason why I put these LUTs together, to help you better expose. By using these LUTs on the field on your monitor, they will display your images darker, forcing you to lift your ISO up till your image looks proper on your screen. For those of you who did buy my Blackmagic LUTs, thank you guys so very much. I truly appreciate all the support, all the kind words, and all the feedback. It's actually just been super awesome seeing that. Thank you guys so much again for watching. There will be more color grading tutorials coming out soon. Again, this video was just touching on Blackmagic RAW, but I do plan on releasing more in-depth color grading tutorials in the coming weeks here. I'm not gonna lie, I have a whole lot going on my plate, so I do apologize that I'm not able to pump out these videos quicker, but duty calls, sometimes you gotta work, you gotta pay the bills. I'm sure you guys know how it is. We do have a lot of really fun stuff coming on top of color grading tutorials. We're gonna be reviewing sliders, gimbals, filters, you name it, all sorts of fun stuff. I'm really looking forward to it, guys. If you did enjoy this video, give it a like, and if I earned a sub, heck yeah, I love it. Thank you guys for watching, I appreciate it, and I will see you in the next video. Take care.